studio.
Hey, this is Steve Byrne. How are you?
Steve Byrne! You're a Pittsburgher, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, so there's two things Pittsburghers are. We're extremely loyal.
Yes.
And brutally honest.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so if a Pittsburgher says you're fat, face the mirror, Tubby, you're a fatty boombaletti. Am I right?
Yes.
Your new documentary, Always Amazing, the true story of the life, death, and return of the amazing Johnathan. I did not like it.
You did not like it. Well,
I freaking loved it.
Well, I appreciate that. I knew there was a setup here, so.
Holy
shit. I spelled it out.
Holy crap, dude. This is coming from a guy who does nothing but watch stand-up comics on Netflix and documentaries, and this is the best of both worlds.
Oh, well, thank you very much. That's a great way to put it, but there's a lot of comedy in it, and there's the narrative of a documentary. So, yeah, I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
My problem is there's so many twists and turns in this documentary. I'm really reluctant to kind of explain it.
Yeah, I see what you're doing. You're passing the buck. I'll take the lateral.
Nice.
So the amazing Johnathan, a lot of people may or may not remember. He's a comedian, really popular in the 90s, early 2000s, wore a headband. Freddy Krueger of comedy is what he used to be marketed as. And just popped off of Comedy Central, touring the world, and ended up becoming a Vegas headliner and was making millions upon millions of dollars. And at the time, he's given a terminal diagnosis due to cardiomyopathy, so it's a degradation of his heart. So he retired from performing. And basically outlived the doctor's expectations and got tired of waiting around and dying, said, I'm going to make a return to the stage. I'm going to see if I still got it. And he went back, and I just, as a friend, I had heard that he's going to go back to the stage. And I thought, oh, somebody's got to make a film. This would be a great documentary. And I just said, the hell with it. I'll just do it. So I grabbed some cameras and some friends, and we went out and filmed it, and here we are.
It's amazing, dude. I had forgotten how funny he was and is. And is he still alive?
He is still alive, and he, you know, it's tough because he doesn't have much wick left. You know, he has some good patches. He's got his bad days. But my goal certainly was to get this film finished before he unfortunately is no longer with us. So that was always a goal of mine, and we did do that. And I'll tell you, we screened it for him a few months ago at his theater room, and he just looked at me at the end of the film, and he said, I love it. And he got up and walked out. And I knew he was collecting himself, and that just meant the world to me. So I was really, really floored by that. And, yeah.
The only complaint I have, Ding Dong, you don't give a film like this away for free.
Well, yeah. So it's on YouTube. You type in Always Amazing, and you'll get to watch the movie for free, literally for free, no strings attached. There's no ads in it. I didn't want to monetize it. We've blown away any expectations or goals that we had. It's got like 133,000 views in just literally just a few days. The response, the comments, the likes, the dislikes is off the charts. And the reason I did this is because, much to my wife's chagrin, my good friend Bill Burr and Al Magical was talking to these guys, and basically I could recoup a small percentage of what I put into this. Mm-hmm. But given Johnathan's legacy and everything he's accomplished and just how funny he is, I thought, I want as many people to see this. I want more people to see this than I care about the money. So I thought, what's accessible? What does everybody have? Everybody has YouTube. And there we go.
So what was your relationship with Johnathan?
So when I first started, I was a young comic in New York City. The first time I ever hit the road, I went to a club called Goodnights. And to make money, you had to work 2 weeks back-to-back. So my first week was Brian Regan. My second week was the amazing Johnathan.
Wow.
And Johnathan and I got along really well, along with his road manager, Joel Osborne, who's really featured in the film. Now, while Johnathan's the face of the film, Joel is the heart of the film. And Johnathan, basically when he was touring Australia, he met a young boy at 12 years old who was backstage and wanted an autograph. And every year Johnathan came back to Australia, this kid was backstage wanting to get an autograph. Basically took him under his wing, and at 18 years old, hired Joel to become his road manager. And Joel moves out to Vegas and becomes a road manager for a drug addict. So Joel basically saw him through a nasty divorce, suicide attempt, drug addiction, got his life in order, got him in a good place, went back to Australia, Joel, and then became a comedian on his own. When Johnathan announced he's coming back to stage, Joel came back to open for him. So the whole film kind of comes full circle.
Now, let me preface it, you know, when he meets a 12-year-old, it's nothing creepy.
It is nothing creepy. That's so funny because some people think, oh, here we go, here
yeah,
we go. But it's the absolute opposite of Finding Neverland. It's a really, you know, the whole film is based off of this wonderful fraternal relationship that on paper should never exist, but for some reason these two men came into each other's lives and were always there for each other. And to me, that was the heart and soul and reason. It was the true reason why I did this film.
So you knew Joel, and so you knew the whole kind of backstory about Amazing Johnathan, and that what? All right. So what prompted you to really put this whole thing together yourself?
Well, what prompted me to do it all was because I knew Johnathan, I knew Joel, and I knew them so well. I knew their relationship so well that when Johnathan announced he's coming back to stage, I could almost see the whole film play out in my mind. And I was like, I know how to do this. And I reached out to Johnathan and said, hey, can I film your shows? He said, of course. And I got in touch with Joel, and I said, hey, I think I know how to pull this off. So I kind of ran it by each of them first, and they were both absolutely game. And I think what we turned out was, look, it's really resonating with people. I think sometimes when you make these films, you can test screen them, and you think you got it, right? But, I mean, you look at the response. Like, YouTube is a vicious place, and
yeah.
We've had pretty much nothing but positive comments on the whole film, so it's been rewarding.
All right, so some of the bad comments have to be hilarious because they must not have seen the whole film. What are some of the responses on YouTube that you just like, really?
Well, the one I saw that made me laugh was somebody said, like, I really enjoyed the film, but Steve put his social media in the credits. So, like, it says, directed by Steve Byrne, that says, at Steve Byrne Live. And this guy went off on me, called me a douche, didn't appreciate it. But it's like, when you do a movie for free, you're going to get mad at me because I'm promoting myself on social. I didn't even put myself in the movie, dude. That would be douchey. Believe me, I've been doing all these podcasts and interviews.
Yeah.
I've done, like, Bobby Lee, Bert Kreischer, Bill Burr. And, you know, you read these comments, and I've gotten called Asian Elon Musk more times than I've ever been in my life. I just hope Elon Musk gets called the white Steve Byrne. That's my goal.
You should do stand-up.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Oh, dude. It's fabulous. It's fabulous. Oh, all right, what is the praise that you've received that most surprised you? Because there's got to be people who are like, it blew me away. It absolutely blew me away.
What's been really nice is just within the comedy community, all my comedian friends texting me, you know, just saying, hey, I just watched the doc. I had an opportunity. I really loved it. And I think it resonates with a lot of comics because I think that, you know, every comic can, in some form or fashion, see themselves in this movie, and you're almost watching your career unfold in a nostalgic way. It's kind of like, you know, it's your life all unfolding and unpacking for you. So, I, you know, that was one of the things that resonated with me when we end with this great montage of Johnathan performing, but recollecting all of his wonderful events throughout the years. And I don't know, to me, when I saw that for the very first time when we were cutting it, I did get emotional watching that.
Yeah, it's a fabulous film. And you know what? Knowing that you've a Pittsburgh, as a Pittsburgher, I'm very proud of what you put together on film. It really is like, wow, this is a really great accomplishment. I had forgotten how funny it is. I forgot how many lines I've stolen from Johnathan over these years.
Ma'am, do you like birds? That's one of my favorites. Just give somebody the finger.
So with that, it's free. It's online. It's the Always Amazing, the True Story of the Life, Death, and Return of the Amazing Johnathan. My next question is, you're hitting the road. When are you coming to Pittsburgh?
I know I'm coming to the Pittsburgh Improv in December. That is for sure. So I'm really excited about that. And any opportunity to get back to Pittsburgh is always welcome for me. I was just there a week ago because I was filming some exterior shots for a feature film I have that I wrote and directed about my early years in stand-up. That'll be coming out probably in early 2020. And I'm really excited about that one. It really will give people a glimpse of what it's like to truly be on the road. And it's got a great cast. This one's not a documentary. It's produced by my good friend Vince Vaughn, and just a crazy cast of comedians. So I'm really excited and proud for that one to come out.
And you also have something coming up, that a documentary about your brother?
No, that I'm currently working on now.
Okay.
Once I finish this feature film, I'm going to get to work on another feature about my brother and I. So, yeah, that's down the line.
Dude, you work like a Pittsburgher, man. You're working.
I work like a Pittsburgher. Look, the proudest accomplishment I've ever had as a Pittsburgher, you could take the comedy stuff, you could take these films. I once put away 3 Permani sandwiches in one night.
Damn.
So
no.
I don't know how I did it to this day, but that was recent.
How drunk were you?
I was pretty drunk. I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty rocking. Yeah. For
all
sure.
Right. Well, I've got the dates: December 27th through the 29th at the Improv. That's your stand-up. But I'm going to be on the bandwagon and promoting this documentary because it is amazing. It really is.
Thank you.
And there, I tell you what, there's going to be Hollywood knocking. You're going to do more films with this one, because this one is really well made.
I'm just trying to keep up with Billy Gardell. That's what I'm ultimately doing here. So
you're just fat and happy.
Yeah, exactly. But thank you so much for having me on, Jonny. I truly do. And always, always a pleasure, even if it's via phone. I'm right now back in Pittsburgh, and I love it. So
all right, brother.
You.
Well, when you're in town, please stop by. I'd love to talk to you.
Absolutely.
Good luck with the film. Thank you, Steve.
All right, bye.
Bye-bye.